Well, this is it, Viv. This is the Elvis Presley Honeymoon Hideaway.
This is a great approach.
Isn't it unusual?
It's very feng shui, flowing water.
Flowing water.
Very ahead of its time, I'd have thought.
Circular stones, and when you get inside, you'll see that he carried that circular concept throughout the house.
Mike McLean is an expert on Palm Springs, homes of the rich and famous. His company lets out several properties, like Elvis and Priscilla's honeymoon hideaway, where, at a price, you too can experience firsthand the lifestyle of the stars.
And of course, the living room. Let me show you. This is really neat.
Wow.
Again, circular in design. It looks very much the way it did when Elvis and Priscilla stayed here.
And all the photographs of them on the
photographs
wall.
Photographs showing them actually being here, but look at your indoor-outdoor. You sit here, enjoy your fireplace in middle of December, and yet look out there to a beautiful pool and just lovely, lovely backyard.
And up to a dining area.
This is a dining room. This is where they had their honeymoon dinner, and some of the photographs showing them that. And right through here, another circle, if you will. This is the kitchen.
Whoa.
Circular center
this is
island.
Some kitchen.
It's barbecue.
Barbecue.
Yeah.
My
and
goodness.
Then, by the way, Bev, you better grab some water here as we go outside.
All right,
it's
thank
kind
you.
Of warm.
Thank you.
This is kind of a family room area, more informal. TV and stereo here behind.
Concealed behind,
uh-huh.
there. Mm-hmm.
Exactly. And then, of course, your sliding glass doors out to your lovely pool and patio area. And like many of these older homes, they have the very, very large swimming pools. So you can just envision Elvis Presley lounging around here.
And there are photographs to show that, aren't there?
There's photographs in there of both he and the Memphis Mafia, as they called them, and Priscilla.
Because this was their honeymoon home.
This is where they spent their honeymoon, right, after coming back from Las Vegas. They got married there, had a celebration there, and then flew back here and actually spent their honeymoon here. Elvis had to leave the next day, supposedly. He was still finishing filming on a movie called Clam Bake. So he actually left the following morning, but then he came back. He did lease it for a year, so they used it periodically during that time period.
And does it look largely now as it did then?
Very, very close. The current owners decorated it in such a fashion to represent a similar look as when Elvis was here. The only thing different is back in the 60s, if you recall, they had those shag carpeting. So we don't have the shag carpeting, but beyond that, it looks pretty close.
I saw a photograph of that carpeting.
Yeah.
You could get lost in that.
If you lost a retainer or something, you'd be in deep trouble. Yeah. It was originally designed and built by a famous builder here in Palm Springs by the name of Alexander. And it's very noteworthy because it has the A-frame roof. And as you travel through Palm Springs, you'll see many, many homes that have that very unique A-frame roof. They call those Alexanders. And this was the first prototype. Put yourself back into 1962, this is a very futuristic home. It's built in three circles. You have a indoor barbecue in the kitchen. You have the big Gen Air refrigerators. You have three levels to the home. And again, for 1962, I can imagine that it was very shocking to people, very futuristic.
The roof is very unusual.
Well, the roof line is very unusual, both with the mansard look, with the frame hanging down. It was a flat roof, which is unusual, and you'll notice it's white rock. So it's two purposes. One, the whiteness to reflect the sun's heat, and number two, then, it acts as an insulation so that the heat doesn't penetrate the roof line. Because of our weather, most of the homes incorporate what we call indoor-outdoor living. So that you're not, when you're inside, you're still able to enjoy the outside vis-a-vis looking out your windows and your glass sliding doors. The living room was more of a formal living room and was designed in that fashion. So the family room den area would have been this room here off the kitchen where you'd have your TV and your stereo system and so on.
So as well as all the authenticated pieces of his life, you've got a few of the tackier sort of things as well.
Yeah, we don't have any velvet pictures, though, that I can see. So, but you're right, there's a couple of them that are questionable. But different strokes for different folks.
Absolutely.
You know?
But of course, the jukebox as well is a wonderful thing.
Isn't that neat? That's probably vintage 1960s. And of course, it has an abundance of Elvis Presley songs on it. So people really get a kick out of that when you turn that on and And when you're showing the home or escorting people through, to have some Elvis songs going. Yeah.
Well, it's hard to be a gambler betting on the number that changes every time. When you think you're gonna win, you think she's giving in. A stranger's all you'll find.
There's a huge bedroom downstairs that has its own master bath that any of us would consider as a adequate master bedroom today, even though it wasn't. Is the master bedroom of the honeymoon suite is upstairs. So there are actually three bedrooms downstairs and the honeymoon suite upstairs. So for you have a total of four bedrooms plus a little office area. So that, again, in the situation with Elvis Presley and his entourage, there was adequate sleeping arrangements and privacy for the bathrooms for the guys that spent their time here, so that there was no intrusion on Elvis Presley and his bride. Again, they were upstairs, but there was adequate bedrooms and baths downstairs for all his people.
Well, I just can't help it.
Can we talk about the honeymoon suite? It's pretty striking.
Very, very unusual. Again, it's at the top of the house, and again, it is the third circle that's sitting. You have the middle area and then this very top circle area, which is the honeymoon suite and master bath. And it's very unusual. Beautiful views of the city. The bed is a replica of the bed as it appeared, as it was when Elvis spent time here. If you saw the bathroom, very unique, black and white tile. Squares. It has a sunken jacuzzi tub, which again was very, very hard to find in those days. From the moment that Elvis Presley stayed here, he had a fascination with jacuzzis and jacuzzi tubs. So all the houses that he stayed in and he constructed after this time, he made certain that there was a big sunken tub jacuzzi in them.
What does it cost?
This home rents out during the season at $1,500 a night, which really, when you look at it, four couples, five couples, and you start dividing it, it's very, very reasonable in comparison to what a suite at a hotel would cost you. So it's the homes themselves are very, very popular.
And of course you get the swimming pool.
You get the pool and you get all the memories, and if you're not careful, sometimes at night you might hear Elvis singing and the jukebox not on, so I don't know.
The ghost of Elvis Presley.
The ghost of Elvis. Yeah, we see him everywhere, so you might as well see him here, right?
That's right.
Yeah. I've heard that Priscilla has come back once or twice prior to my involvement in it. And as I said, a lot of the people that were associated with Elvis have been back for a specific occasion.
So there are a lot of people around still with the memory of him being here.
Yeah, there's a lot of people in the desert still remember his being here and his impact.